are back live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center for the final 1993 state championship game in Class B between the number one ranked Wahoo Warriors and the unranked Hardington Cedar Catholic ball club, who won their way in with a 48-47 win over SCOTUS and a 54-50 win over Grand Island Northwest. A lot of people are saying, how in the world did an unranked team slide in here and get in the championship game with the number one ranked team? Well, they just played tough basketball, but they'll have their hands full tonight on a team that's won 138 out of the last 139 ball games. Wahoo, 24-0 under Mick Anderson in his 17th year. They beat Sydney 65-49, Crete 77-58. 26th year at state. They were champions way back in 1926, and then 4 years in a row, 88, 89, 90, and 91. Last year, Ogallala snapped their win streak at 114, and Pius went on to claim the title. They averaged 93 points on defense, give up 48. Hardington Cedar Catholic, under Bob Gary in his fifth year. They average 70 points a game, give up 52. They beat SCOTUS. The score there was 48-47. Then they beat Grand Island Northwest 54-50. 10th trip to the state. They were here last year, champs in 80 and 84.
Ed, take a bow.
So Ed Childress, they're announcing Ed Childress. For 40 years he's been around here. And he will be retiring tonight. I've known Ed for a long, long time. Well, let's get our non-starter introductions here for the visiting Trojans of Hardington Cedar Catholic.
Their non-starting team members are number 15, Scott McGregor.
Number 15 is Scott McGregor, a 6-foot junior. Number 21 is John.
Number 21, John Arns,
a 5'9 senior. 35 is Mark Keene, 6'1 junior. 41, Brian Kinney, 6'3 sophomore. 45 is Russ Hookstein, 6'4 freshman. 53 is Paul Howey, 6'3 sophomore. He's their first substitute, averages 7 a game, 5 rebounds. 55 is Dwayne Becker, 6'4 junior. Here are the starters for the 21-2 Hardington Cedar Catholic Trojans. Their only losses have been to Wayne, which they avenged, and to Battle Creek. Or I should say to South Sioux City. Scott Heine is a 6-foot senior, 4 a game, 2 rebounds. Aaron Frank, 6'2 senior, 13 a game, 3 rebounds. Jamie Jones, 6'5 sophomore, 10 a game, 6.5 rebounds. Their leading scorer is Eric Mueller, a 6'3 senior, 18.5 a game, 6.5 rebounds. He has 34 points in the tournament. And Dennis Pinkelman, a 6'3 senior, 11.5 a game, 7 rebounds. And he's averaged 13 points a game here in the tournament. So their leading scorer is Eric Mueller, their leading rebounder, Dennis Pinkelman. For the undefeated number one ranked Wahoo Warriors, the non-starters are Louis Wotipka, a 5'10 junior. Brett Eady is a 6-foot senior. Tim Bohati, 6-foot senior. Mike Simon, 6-foot freshman. Ryan Glock, the number one player off the bench, is a 6'1 senior. And Dan Brown is a 6'2 freshman. The starters for Wahoo all average in double figures. The coach's son, Justin Anderson, is a 6'3 senior, 13 a game, 5 rebounds. He has 12 in the tournament. Joel Wyant, a 6-foot senior, 22.5 a game. He has 30 points in the tournament, 15 in both games. Greg Hine, a 6-foot junior, 12 a game, 5 rebounds. He has 15 points in the tournament. Travis Tolleen, 6'4 junior, 13 a game, 6.5 rebounds. He has 32 on the tournament. And their leading scorer in the state tournament has been Mike Hancock, a 6'1 junior. On the regular season, 18 a game, 4 rebounds, but he's got 42 points in the tournament. Wahoo has certainly been the class of Class B for the last several years, winning four straight times, 88, 89, 90, and 91. That one was a miracle deal against Pius, but they all count. We've seen a lot of those last-second miracle games here in this state tournament. So it's the number one ranked Wahoo Warriors going against unranked Hardington Cedar Catholic. So here we go. And the final boys state championship game. We've had two blowouts and three close ones. Two of the close ones were in overtime. Many people think that Hardington Cedar Catholic, that the Trojans can't stay with Wahoo, but time will tell. They've had two really close games. They haven't had a chance to rest their players as Wahoo has. Here we go. Tolene will go up against Jamie Jones. Wahoo's crowd has been here since 5 o'clock. The opening tip goes to Cedar Catholic. Basketball to Aaron Frank. Wyant's all over him and the man-to-man as he comes across the timeline. Off it goes to Dennis Pinkelman. Now they clear on the right wing to Heine. Cross-court pass to Mueller. Mueller, their leading scorer. Skip pass over the top. I'm sure Cedar Catholic would love to keep this slowed down. Now traveling is called on Mueller. Randy Brohorst from Lincoln whistles a traveling call. Here come the Warriors. As we say, all five of their starters in double figures. And their leading scorer, Wyatt, handles the basketball off to Tolene. Tolene clears it off to Hine. Now to Hancock. They work it around the perimeter. There's Hine. They are yet to get Justin Anderson in there. There comes Justin. Greg Hine drives. Tries to dish it off. Oh, saved by Justin Anderson. There's Hancock's three-point shot. It's going to be off the mark. Losing the rebound is Heine. Down low, Hancock drives off the glass. He's fouled and it scores. Cedar Catholic made the mistake of losing the rebound, and it ended up costing him two, maybe three. Mike Hancock is fouled by Jamie Jones. Here's the three-point attempt by Hancock. As we say, he's been their leading scorer in the tournament. The Southpaw puts it up, and bingo. 3-0, Wahoo. Full court pressure. With the basketball is Heine. Up court it comes to Aaron Frank, and he turns it over. Aaron Frank had a player right in his face. That was Hancock. Another turnover for Cedar Catholic. Here's Joel Wyatt. A lot of scouts taking a look at Joel. Justin Anderson. Off it goes to Hine. Wyatt's three-point shot. Counted. Wow. If you blink, you missed the ball going through the basket. 6-0, Wahoo. Again, the full court pressure. Heine gets it off. Oh, stolen away by Hancock. Bounce pass to Wyatt. Wyatt misses the shot, but he's fouled on the way in. And down, getting up slowly, is Heine. Boy, Wahoo put so much pressure on you. And I mean not just pressure, but I mean tough pressure. First foul on Heine, second team foul against the Trojans. And here's Joel Wyant. Grandson of a man who coached for years here in Lincoln. Free throw is good. I think he's the basketball coach over at Lincoln High. 6:26 left to go, and Wahoo is already up 7-0. They average 93 points a game. Count the second one. So Hancock has three, Wyant five. It's 8-0 Wahoo. Frank lobs it in the front court. Grabbing the basketball is Jones. Back out it comes. They get a three-point shot by Jones in the corner, misses. The rebound by Mueller. Mueller's 10-footer, rolls around, drops in. Eric Mueller gets it down for the first two of the night for Cedar Catholic. On the other end, Justin Anderson fakes it. Kicks it out to Hine. Inside it goes to Tolene. Tolene drives, scoop shot, misses. Rebound by Pinkelman. Quickly up court. Mueller has the ball knocked away by Hancock. Gets it out to Frank. Three-point shot. Oh, won't go. Rebound by Anderson. Justin drops it off for Wyatt. Wyatt flies into the front court. Three-point shot by Hancock. Won't go. Boxing out beautifully with the rebound is Eric Mueller. 5.5 left to go. First quarter, it's 8-2 Wahoo. Wahoo has one loss in the last 139 games. Ogallala is proud to have snapped that streak, and now he's got traveling called against Pinkelman. So after being a little bit intimidated early, it seemed like Cedar Catholic had gotten back in the flow, but they turn it over there. Here come the Warriors by six, and now we've got traveling call on Hancock. They were going to try and backdoor Greg Hine, and the Cedar Catholic player got in the way, and Hancock travels. There's the inbounds to Frank. Frank to Jamie Jones, being pressured in the backcourt, gets across the timeline. Skips it up over the top to Aaron Frank. Frank, off it goes to Mueller on the right side. Aaron Frank drives and is fouled in there by Greg Hine. Coach Bob Gary in his fifth year just trying to right his ship here. Pulled him in this in the early going. Wahoo jumped off to an 8-0 lead. They now leave 8-2. 4:55 left to go. They lob it in to Mueller. Mueller's 10-footer good. Eric Mueller with all four of the points for Wahoo, or for Cedar Catholic. On the other end, Wyatt pulls up. 18-footer. It won't go. Boxing out, grabbing the rebound is Pinkelman. So right now it's one shot and out. About halfway through the first quarter. Final championship game of 1993. With the basketball is Heine. Bounce pass inside, gets away. There's a lead pass to Wyatt. Wyatt loses it, but trailing the play and picking it up is Justin Anderson. We're halfway through the first quarter. There's Justin Anderson's first shot. It misses. No good. And Heine saves it. Nope, steps out of bounds. Coming in for Cedar Catholic is 53, Paul Howie, a 6'3 sophomore. And out goes Pinkelman. And now we've got a timeout. 4:01 left to go first quarter. Wahoo 8, Hardington Cedar Catholic 4. Wahoo jumped out to an 8-0 lead, but since then, Cedar Catholic's been able to have that. As play resumes, the Wahoo Warriors, Joel Wyant, will inbounds, left of his own basket. Looking, lobs it in to Hancock. Hancock's 14-footer is good. 5 points for Hancock and 5 for Wyatt. Now there's the steal. They lose it back. Eric Mueller. Mueller drives against Toline, and Toline picks up the foul. Justin Anderson and Wyatt went down at midcourt trying to steal the basketball. Toline trying to defend on a 2-on-1 break picks up the foul. Eric Mueller, the first player at the line in this game. He's got all 4 points for the Trojans. Make it 5. So just 3 players have scored so far. Wyatt and Hancock for the Warriors. And Mueller misses this one. Running it down is Justin Anderson. Wyatt quickly in the front court. Heine's got him. Wyatt kicks it out to Hancock. Back to Wyatt. Wyatt drives down the baseline. He's cut off and fouled in there by Jones. Second foul on Jamie Jones. 3:35 remaining in the first quarter. Wahoo has doubled the score on Cedar Catholic. Pinkelman is back in, and out comes Jamie Jones, who has 2. Well, we have him with 2. Justin Anderson inbounds. Three-point shot by Hancock from downtown. It bounces around, won't go. They battle for the rebound. It's knocked out to Eric Mueller. Mueller being run down from behind, has the ball knocked away by Hine, picked up by Wyatt. Down court, wide open is Toline. Toline scores. That was all caused by Wyatt on the other end. And now the ball knocked away and stolen by Justin Anderson. Pass up court, deflected out of bounds. Wahoo with the tempo going their way. Boy, you just have to take care of it for 32 minutes against these guys. Hancock will throw it in across the way as Wahoo has built their lead to 7. 3:05 remaining first quarter. Wyatt quickly across the timeline. Drops it off for Toline. Now against the 1-3-1 zone. Hancock, who will cast it up from anywhere on the court. Wyatt, Hancock. In the corner it goes to Justin Anderson. Back to Hancock. Hancock's three-point shot. Bingo. Wow. This guy, when he comes across the timeline, he's ready to put it up. Quick long up-court pass to Howie. Howie pulls up. His 13-footer won't go. Rebound, Greg Hine. Outlet pass, Wyatt. Two-on-three break. Wyatt down low. Shot by Hine. Up good. Hine scores. Hine scores off the assist by Wyatt. Passes in the front court to Mueller, and now we got timeout called. Timeout, Cedar Catholic. And Coach Bob Gary is out on the officials. With 2:12 left first quarter, Wahoo 17, Cedar Catholic 5. Wahoo has reeled off 7 straight points. And right now, Cedar Catholic is reeling. It's like a gale just went through and blew him over. With the basketball is Mueller. Off it goes to Pinkelman. He's tripped. And a 3-second violation. Randy Brohorst didn't see the steal. Called a 3-second violation, but it'll still be Wahoo's ball. Wyatt. Slowly across the timeline. 1:55 to go. Keep in mind, these guys average 93 points a game. Hine wraparound pass to Toline, and Toline traveled. Aaron Frank got in his face, and Toline tried to outmaneuver him and outmaneuvered himself. Jamie Johnson is in, and out goes Scott Heine for Cedar Catholic with 1:47 left to go in the quarter. Against the pressure, Pinkelman. Long up-court pass to Jones in the front court to Mueller. Mueller pulls up, 15-footer, won't go. Rebound, Toline. Outlet pass to Wyatt. Wyatt is going to slow it up, drop it off. Justin Anderson for 3. It's in and out, no good. Rebound, Hancock has it. Put back, it's good. Hancock with 10 points already in the first quarter, and now a foul on Hancock. Most of their fouls are certainly because they're not under-aggressive. I'll say that for him. Mick Anderson has his kids flying all over the place. He wants to put a little backcourt pressure on him. Here's Jones in the front court. It comes to Howie. Off it goes to Jamie Jones. The ball is stolen away by, or knocked loose by Joel Wyatt. Picked up by Hancock on the run. Wyatt back to Hancock, misses. They battle for the boards. And coming down with the rebound is Jamie Jones. 57 seconds left to go. Frank gets it in the front court to Jones. Off it goes to Pinkelman. Shot up, no good. Rebound, Hancock. Outlet, Wyatt, and here they come on the transition. Wyatt pulls up, 17-foot shot short, no good. One shot and out, grabbing the rebound is Howie to Jones. 38 seconds left to go, 19-5. Off it goes, three-point shot is up, and no good by Jamie Jones. Again, the rebound to the Warriors. And now they'll slow it down for one shot. As Wyatt dribbles over and Mick Anderson hollers out the final play of the first quarter. Wahoo by 14. Will it be more than that? Will they be in the 20s when it's all over? Toline, right wing to Wyatt. Off it comes Hancock's three-point shot. It won't go. Rebound, Eric Mueller. There's a long desperation shot that's out of bounds, and they're going to let down to 2 seconds, or two-tenths of a second. They forgot to stop the clock when it went out of bounds. They let about a second and a half reel off. And the people over at the scorer's table realize that. But there's nothing they can do about it now. Long down court pass. Justin Anderson's shot is up and no good. So at the end of the quarter, Wahoo 19, Hardington Cedar Catholic 5. The score for Cedar Catholic in that first quarter was Eric Mueller with 5. Mike Hancock by himself doubled that score. He had 10 in the first quarter. Wahoo by 14. Well, we're going to have three close games and three blowouts today. We've had three close games, two blowouts. Let's see how this one turns out. Wyatt to Hine. Hine dribbles, has the ball knocked away, picked up in there by Pinkelman. Hine got stripped of the basketball. In the front court comes Frank. Lobs it off for Jones to Heine. In the corner to Mueller. Mueller's three-point shot is too strong. Rebound, Greg Hine, so it's one and out. Wyant off the dribble, gets it to Hancock. Corner to Justin Anderson. Down low, wide open is Toline. Short bank shot, no good, but he's fouled down low by Mueller. No, by 43. That's Pinkelman. The Warriors do a great job of working away from the basket.
First foul, 14th foul and a half on Hardington Cedar Catholic.
Here's Toline at the line.
A 55%
free throw shooter. The first one is no good. Second one, and it is good. Took a while to convince that one to go down. Cedar Catholic plays it in against the full court pressure. They break the pressure. Frank pulls up. 12-footer is no good, and the foul is going to be on Hine. Second foul on Hine. Was he in the act?
Foul is on Greg Hine.
Yep. Aaron Frank steps to the line.
Second foul. 14 foul and a half on Wahoo.
7:14 until intermission.
Aaron Frank at the free throw line for Hardington.
Frank is a 6'2 senior, 66% free throw shooter, and this is good. He becomes only the second player to score for Cedar Catholic. Second one is, it took a while, but it went down. 20-7, 13-point lead for Wahoo. Number one ranked against unranked Hardington Cedar Catholic. Wyant kicks it out to Hancock. Hancock, off it goes to Justin Anderson. Three-point shot by Hancock. It's off the front of the ring. Rebound, Aaron Frank. Frank flies into the front court and a reach-in foul on Wyant. Wyant picks up his first 15 foul on the Warriors.
Foul on Joel Wyant in the first foul, 15 foul and a half on Wahoo.
Heine flips it in to Frank. Off it goes to Mueller, inside to Pinkelman. Pinkelman's fall away jump shot, no good. But the tip shot is up and in by Jones. Jamie Jones with a tip in. 11-point lead for Wahoo. Wyant. Off it goes to Anderson. Hine left wing. Brings it up top. Skips it down the right-hand corner to Hancock. Hancock off to Anderson. Justin pulls up, 17-footer, short, no good. Rebound, Heine. Cedar Catholic, up court, throws it away. Boy, the coaches up stomping their feet after that one. They realize they've got to take advantage of every scoring chance they get, and they throw it away. Well, I'll tell you, Wahoo gets up and down the court in a hurry. 2 minutes into the second quarter, they lead 20-9. Things have slowed up just a little bit. They've only scored 1 point so far in the first 2 minutes. For them, that's unbelievable. Three-point shot, Hancock. Uh-uh. Rebound, Mueller. So it's one and out. Long down court pass. Coming up with it is Jones, and he scores.
Jamie Jones
has got Cedar Catholic back within 9. Lob inside to Tolene. Tolene short bank shot, no good, but the putback is good by Hine. Boy, you go to help out against one of their players and they leave someone open and it costs you. Long pass in the front court to Jones. Cross court pass to Frank. His 17-footer is no good. And the rebound, there's a foul on Heine. Second on Heine. 15 foul against the Trojans. Both teams have five team fouls, and now we got a timeout. With 5:17 remaining in the first half, it's Wahoo 22, Hardington Cedar Catholic 11. Well, it's a sort of a moral victory, if nothing else, for Cedar Catholic. They've held Wahoo to just 3 points in the first 3 minutes of the second quarter. While Cedar Catholic was scoring six, but the Warriors have still been able to double the score at 22-11. They're going for their fifth state championship in the last 6 years. The string was only broken by Pius last year. With the basketball is Hine. Out it comes Justin Anderson. Wyatt penetrates, kicks it off to Hine. Lobs it inside, and it's stolen away by Pinkelman. Lob for Tolene, picked off by Pinkelman. Aaron Frank brings it in and drops it off for Heine. Eric Mueller to Jones. Inside it goes to Pinkelman. Back out to Frank. They work it around against the 1-3-1 zone. Inside to Pinkelman, and Pinkelman's tied up. On the alternate possession, it'll stay with Cedar Catholic. Cedar Catholic just trying to stay close. Mueller gets it into Jones. Again, inside it goes. Turnaround shot by Jones is good. Jamie Jones now has six all here in the second quarter. 9-point lead for Wahoo. Wyatt to Hine. He'll come up top and look. He'll reverse his dribble, go for the basket. Scoop shot, no good. Rebound, Mueller, and a foul on Hine. Third foul on Hine. That's going to send him to the bench. And here comes number 44, Ryan Glock. In for Cedar Catholic, number 53, Paul Howey. So Cedar Catholic's got a chance to chisel that lead down to seven. They trailed by 14 at halftime, or at the end of the first quarter. Mueller back out to Frank. Skip pass over the top to Heine, to Jones. Jones almost has his pocket pick. Gets it back. Off to Mueller. Mueller drives. Shovels it off to Frank. Frank's looping hook shot in the lane. No good. Rebound, Justin Anderson. Outlet, Wyatt. Down court pass knocked away and almost saved by Frank. Frank almost picked it off and then went sliding out of bounds trying to save it. Justin Anderson into Wyatt. Tolene, they reverse it around to Anderson on the right wing. Up top it comes to Wyatt. Heine's in his face. Shovels it off to hit to number 44, Glock is in there. Down low, they get it to Anderson, and he's fouled behind from behind by his counterpart number, and that's Aaron Frank. So with 3:27 left to go, neither team's been to the line for 1-1 yet, but the next one will put either one of them in. 22-13, Wahoo, as they play it in. There's a three-point shot by Hancock. Bingo. About the time you think you're back in the ball game, they can a three. There's a lob pass down court, and they throw it away. Cedar Catholic trying to get back in her. Had it down to nine. Off it goes. It's deflected away. Pass for Tolene, deflected away. Heine comes up with it and travels. Gary Pence called the traveling. And now timeout. Exactly 3 minutes remaining in the first half. Wahoo 25, Hardington Cedar Catholic 13. For you. What's the lowest offensive output of the year for Wahoo? Well, 76 points, believe it or not, by Syracuse. Right now, they've only got 25 points in the first 13 minutes. Wyatt will inbounds. Joel flips it in to Hancock. Hancock down low, it goes to Glock, saves it from going out of bounds, flips it out front. Wyatt, off it goes to Glock. They work it around right wing to Justin Anderson. There's his three-point shot. It's going to be off the mark. High to grab the rebound is Eric Mueller. Boy, he got up there on that one. Cedar Catholic's had several chances to get back in, and they've turned it over. There's a pass inside. Off it goes to Frank. 12-footer won't go. Rebound Heine, and he is fouled by Anderson. So that will send Frank to the line to shoot one and one. Well, they've done a great job of holding Wahoo to just 25 points. The trouble is, Wahoo's done a great job of holding them to 13. One and one for Heine, looking for his first points, and he misses. Rebound, Glock. Ryan runs it down and drops it off for Joel Wyatt. 2:20 and counting down in the first half. Now Wyatt. Directing traffic. Cross-court pass to Hancock. Lob down low to Toline. Toline goes up and gets it down. Nice lob pass from Hancock. Toline with five. 27 to 13. That's the same lead they enjoyed at the end of the first quarter. It was 14 points. There's a pass to Frank. Frank drives in. Shot is up, no good, but a foul on Hancock. Hancock, who reeled off 10 points in the first quarter, has been scoreless in the first 6 minutes of the second quarter. Checking in for Cedar Catholic is 43 Pinkelman, and out goes Howie.
Two shots.
Frank is right back at the free throw line where he missed a little bit ago. He's got this one. Here's his second attempt, and it's good. 4 points for Frank. 27 to 14 with 1:55 left to go in the half. Wahoo in control of the game, but certainly not smoking the nets tonight. Justin Anderson, Wyatt. Wyatt reverses dribble, drops it off low to Toline. Toline is the benefactor of a beautiful Wyatt pass. Toline gets the bucket, Wyatt the assist. 14 points. The lead for Wahoo. There's a deflected pass, but getting it back is Frank. Down low to Heine. Heine gets in behind the defense and scores. Heine with his first two. Cedar Catholic kind of hanging in there. There's a running jump shot by Toline. No good. Rebound Jones. Outlet Frank, and here come the Trojans with a chance to get back within 10. They had it down to 9 earlier. There's a pass deflected away, and there's a foul in the backcourt on Mueller. Deflected by Anderson, picked off by Hancock, foul Mueller. Boy, it's got to be frustrating to play these guys. About the time you feel you're getting ready to climb back in the game, they just run away from you. 29 to 17, Wahoo by 12 as Hancock goes to the line where he's 1-for-1. As we mentioned earlier, Hancock's been their leading scorer in the tournament with 42 points. His free throw is good. He now has 14. 14 of Wahoo's 30 points belong to Mike Hancock. Misses the second one. Rebound is hauled down in there by Pinkelman. Here comes Frank with less than a minute remaining. They've been able to outscore Wahoo, believe it or not, by 1 point. Inside, Pinkelman's 10-footer is good. Dennis Pinkelman gets his first two. 30 to 19 with 40 seconds left to go in the first half. That's Justin Anderson. Off it goes to Ryan Glock, and he'll drop it off for Wyatt. So Wahoo will lead by at least 11, it looks like, as it's down to 30 seconds. Wyatt, off it goes to Justin Anderson, to number 54 Hancock. 20 seconds remaining. To Wyatt. They've got so many three-point shooters. Who ends up shooting it? Now it's down to 14 seconds as they kick it in gear. Tolene, Ryan Glock in the corner. Oh, Wyant's wide open. Here comes a shot, and it won't go. But we got a pushing off foul underneath on the rebound. And it's going to be on Justin Anderson. With 5.5 seconds left to go, they will send Cedar Catholic to the line. Anderson's second foul as 53 Howie comes in, and out goes Jones. Pinkelman, who's a 57% free throw shooter, is at the line. 21 John Arns is in for Cedar Catholic. So they got to be happy if they make these two. And if Wahoo doesn't score, it'll be at least in single digits. That free throw is no good. Rebound, Tolene. Tolene. Off to Wyant. Long down court pass. Out of the corner, Justin Anderson misses. It wouldn't have counted anyway. So it's a much more low-scoring game, at least for Wahoo, than a lot of people thought. At the half, Wahoo 30, Hardington Cedar Catholic 19. Well, about the only surprising thing about the first half is the fact that Wahoo's been held to 30 points. They lead by 11. And here's our unofficial scoring. Mike Hancock with 14 to lead all scorers. Also for Wahoo, Tolene has 7, 5 for Wyatt, and 4 for Hine. Over on the Cedar Catholic side, Jones has 6, Mueller 5, 4 for Frank, and 2 each for Heine and Pinkelman. So the Wahoo Warriors with an 11-point lead. And most folks think they're just going through the formalities of claiming their sixth state championship. They won way back in 1926, and then two in the 80s and two in the 90s. So the dynasty continues in Wahoo. The Warriors play it in. That's Hine. Cross-court pass to Anderson. Hancock handles. Justin Anderson. Skip pass down low. Oh, nice pass. Hine shovels it off to Tolene. He almost loses it. They kind of overpassed that time. There's Hancock down low. There's the reverse layup. Nice shot. Greg Hine. Hine went under the basket and actually came out and just looped it up and over the side of the rim. 32-19. They continue to hound the Cedar Catholic Trojans with that full court pressure. They get it across the timeline, and Frank handles Heine. They work it around. Shot open for Frank, but it won't go down. Tolene grabs the board for the Warriors. Wyant down court. Hine in the lane. Five-footer rolls around. It won't go. Rebound, Frank. Well, one thing, they don't waste any time getting up and down the court and pulling the trigger. Heine. Heine kicks it up top to Mueller. There's a three-point shot by Heine. It's off the side of the ring. No good. Frank gets the rebound and is fouled by Wyant. Heine missed, and then Wyant picked up the foul on the rebound. We are a little over a minute into the third quarter, and Wahoo's got two more points. There's the drive by Mueller, collision, blocking foul, Tolene. Travis Tolene has two, all five. No, wait a minute. Hines got three. The other four starters have two. So nothing serious right now, but they don't go to their bench very much. Ryan Glock is about the only one that gets in. Free throw is up and in by Mueller. He's now tied for scoring honors with Jamie Jones. Second one is good.
The last foul was on Travis Pauline. Second foul, second team foul of the half.
Here come the Warriors, up by 11. So Cedar Catholic's not let Wahoo really run away and hide right now. Pass intended inside, picked up by Mueller, and then he loses it out of bounds. That's really been the story for Cedar Catholic, even when they've had a chance to make some sort of run, they sort of shoot themselves in the foot. Quickly, Wahoo inbounds and Wyatt. Right wing it goes to Justin Anderson, to Hine. There's Hancock's three-point shot. It's good. Man, Hancock continues to light it up. 17 points for Mike. And I'll tell you, Jamie Jones thought he had a hand right in his face, and he still got the shot off and made it. Frank off to Pinkelman. They get it around to Heine, inside to Pinkelman. Pinkelman gets the shot up with three men around him. No good. Hancock rebounds. Hancock out of there. It's a three-on-two. Toline tries to shovel it underneath the Heine, and it's knocked out of bounds by Jones. Boy, I'll tell you, you could about wear out two pair of sneakers against these guys, because you better get up and down the court. Wyatt, way out it comes to Heine. 5:45 left to go, third quarter. Inside to Toline, wraparound pass to Heine, scoop shot off the glass, no good. Nice move by Greg Heine as he swung under an outstretched arm, then twisted back and banked it off the glass. 14-point lead for the Warriors of Wahoo. Inside it goes to Jones, they bounce it off his foot and out of bounds. Mike Hancock reached in, slapped that ball off of Jones and out of bounds. Wyatt quickly down court to Justin Anderson. Anderson tries to loop a pass to Toline. It's stolen away by Heine. And now Heine carries the ball. Boy, Coach Bob Gary is just really frustrated across the way. His kids have had three chances to cut into this 14-point lead and just haven't done it. We're 3 minutes into the third quarter. Wyatt off it goes to Heine. Anderson, Hancock shovels it off to Wyatt. Wyatt pulls up from 17. It's good. Joel Wyatt with 7 points, and it's a 16-point Wahoo lead. Off it goes to Jones, up court to Heine. Heine, cross-court pass. Mueller drives and is fouled on the way in, and he's hooked by Anderson. So the coach's son picks up his third foul. And with 4:44 left to go, third quarter. And Wahoo up by 16 points. Heine will inbounds right of his own basket. Heine lobs it in to Frank. Frank tries to penetrate, starts up, has the ball knocked away by Anderson. They've got a break. Wyatt down court to Anderson. Anderson fouled on the way in. He didn't get the basket, but he drew the foul. Boy, he almost got it down before Heine got there. Third foul on Heine. Justin will go to the line to shoot two. Not quite halfway through the third quarter. Justin Anderson looking for his first points of the night, averaged 13 a game on the regular season. He scored just 6 per game in the first two outings in the tournament. His free throw is up and climbs over the front of the ring. He is a 77% free throw shooter. They shoot 65 as a team. 58% from from 2-point land, 44 from 3, and 65 from the line. Anderson makes both. Cedar Catholic lobs it in the front court. Going for the steal is Toline, but he doesn't get Mueller. Mueller drives, banks it off the glass. Mueller now has 9. On the other end, scoop shot is up and in by Heine. 8 points now for Greg Heine. It's 41-23, 18-point lead. Wahoo just slowly but surely. There's a steal by Anderson. Cross-court pass to Heine, back to Anderson. It's 2. Great passing. Now it's up to a 20-point lead. Well, they only had 30 points at halftime, which means they had to score 63 points in the second half to get their average. They may do it. There's a Wyatt going for the intercept, and he picks up the foul. Mick Anderson's up clapping his hands because he knows his kids have swung the momentum in this game. Mick Anderson up, really extolling his kids, and now he's the first one to meet him as they come off. Timeout. On the court with 3:49 left to go in the third period. It's now Wahoo by 20, 43-23. So far in this third quarter, Wahoo's outscored Cedar Catholic 13-4. They've upped their 11-point halftime lead to 20. Jones will inbounds. We mentioned at halftime, there's not a whole lot of enthusiasm for this game, and I think part of it's because Wahoo's just expected to win this game and by a bunch, and they're already up by 20. Pass inside, knocked away. Coming up with Tolene. Off to Anderson. Another turnover for Cedar Catholic. Hancock, Tolene, high post. Clears it off right wing to Anderson. Anderson lobs it across to Wyant. Inside they go. Tolene gets in behind the pack and scores. Travis Tolene got the beautiful lob pass. And there's a foul in the backcourt by Hancock. For Mike, that's his third. Coach has a tough time getting mad at kids when they make aggressive fouls like that, and they're up by 22 points. Hancock is out, replaced by Glock. Mick Anderson in that familiar position of being down on at least one or two knees right in front of the bench. That's where he is most of the game. 3:10 left to go, third quarter. Frank slowly in the front court. Gets it off to Jones. Off it goes to Mueller. Out to Frank, off to Heine. Heine, bounce pass to Frank. His 15-footer is good.
Aaron Frank,
now with 6 points. Still a 20-point lead. Wyant pulls up for the three-point shot. Bingo! 10 points for Wyant. 48-25. As they still haven't put the points up on the board. Cedar Catholic plays it in. 2:40 left to go, third quarter. They're just trying to weather this onslaught. Frank with the basketball. Starts for the basket. Drops it off. Actually was knocked away. Heine missed his shot. No good. Picking up the loose garbage and putting it back in is Howie. 47-27. Wyant in the lane. 10-footer in and out and back in. Joel Wyant really starting to flex his offensive muscle right now. 7 points here in the third, 12 for the game. Jones drives. Off it goes to Frank. Back out to Jones. Cross-court pass to Mueller. Mueller drives. 16-footer. Won't go. Rebound, Justin Anderson. Outlet pass to Wyant. He lost it momentarily. It's loose on the court. Stolen away by Jones. Off it comes to Heine. Back to Jones. Knocked out of bounds by Anderson. It looked like a two-on-one break, but you had a feeling they weren't going to get it home. Heine will play it in. Minute 50 left to go. Third quarter. And now Mueller's pass deflected out of bounds with the quick hands of Greg Heim. Tom Bohati, a six-foot senior, is in and Wyant is out. Three juniors and two seniors in that starting lineup for Wahoo. So they've got a lot of firepower back next year. They lead by 22 with a minute 40 left to go, third quarter. There's a three-point shot by Jones. Won't go. High to grab the rebound is Anderson, fouled from behind by Mueller. That's only the second team foul on Cedar Catholic. 1:37 remaining, third quarter.
Second team foul of the half on Harding from Cedar Catholic.
I think right now Cedar Catholic would settle to keep them under their 93-point average. Here's Hine. That's off to Anderson. Glock lobs it inside to Tolene. Tolene is up and misses, but he was fouled. Nice lob pass from Glock to Tolene. And at the line, Travis Tolene for the second time tonight. He's one out of two, a 55% free throw shooter. All five starters have scored here in the third period. Gives you some idea. That's why they're all in double digits for the year. Tolene's free throw comes up short. Wahoo on their way to claiming their sixth state championship. Second free throw. It's no good. Rebound battle for and coming up with it is Jones. Jones in the backcourt. Off it goes to Aaron Frank. In the front court, he's doubled up. Gets it off to Jones. down in the corner to Mueller. Mueller, bounce pass out to Jones, back to Mueller. There's a shot, it's up, and it won't go. Justin Anderson with another rebound, up court to Hine. 1 minute left to go, Hine drives. Oh, he got the shot up and scores. Oh, unbelievable hang time for Greg Hine. Looked like that David Robinson commercial where he hangs up there forever. Third foul on Mueller. 51-27. Back in is Pinkelman for Hardington Cedar Catholic. Hines' free throw is down. Greg now with 11 points, 7 of them here in the third quarter. Wahoo starting to blow this one out. They're up by 25. There's Frank inside to Pinkelman. Pinkelman shot. Doesn't hit the rim. Off the glass, Justin Anderson, another rebound. Off it comes to Bohati. Cross-court pass, three-point shot by Glock. It's short, no good. Glock gets his own rebound, and then it's fouled in there by Mueller. That going to be four on Mueller? I believe it is.
Fouls on Eric Miller. Fourth foul.
Mueller with his fourth foul. And so Mueller hits the bench. Justin Anderson gets it in to Hine with 30 seconds left to go. Inside to Anderson, and Anderson double dribbles. Nice entry pass from Hines, but Justin double dribbled on his way to the hole. 30 seconds left, and here comes Aaron Frank for Cedar Catholic. Wahoo up by 25. Heine, lob pass to Frank. Frank pulls up, 17-footer, no good. Another rebound for Justin Anderson. And he's picked off the last four boards. Anderson, ball right wing, tries to lob it inside. It's deflected and picked off in there by Pinkelman. Pinkelman on the other end, a shot up by Frank, and no good at the buzzer. So we played three quarters, and Wahoo continues to add to their lead. They lead by 25 at the end of three quarters. All that's between the end of the basketball season in the state of Nebraska for the 92-93 season is 8 minutes. As Wahoo is about to claim their fifth championship in 6 years, they lead by 25 headed into the fourth quarter. Cedar Catholic will play it in. They're going to end up having a great year, but they're going to end up getting blown out here in the championship game. We've had three close games, two of them overtime, and three blowouts. Sterling, Adams, and Wahoo will have the blowouts. Wahoo steals the ball. Wyatt drops it off for Hancock, tries to lob it inside. It's deflected away, picked up by Heine. Heine in the front court, pass. Oh, he almost threw it away. They get it back to Heine. He misses the shot. Tip shot is up and good by Mueller. Eric Mueller with the tip. On the other end, Hine. Started up with a shot, then kicks it off for Anderson. Then to Hancock. Off to Wyatt. Three-point shot is short. No good. The long rebound comes to Heine, and he's fouled by Anderson. That's the fourth foul on Justin Anderson. But all of this makes little or no difference. Wahoo, they can continue to run and gun, but if they have to, they can pull it out and start to milk the clock, even with 7 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. Jones, skip pass over the top. And the way Wahoo plays good defense, inside to Pinkelman, he scores. So the first 4 points of the fourth quarter belong to Cedar Catholic. They're back within 21. Now we've got a collision and a foul on Heine. Heine picks up his fourth foul. So he and Mueller have four. And they'll stay in the lineup. Justin Anderson flips it out to Wyant. Back to Anderson, out of the corner, three-point shot. Somebody got a hand on it. Toline gets the rebound to put back. It's no good. Then they scrap for the rebound. Held ball. Alternate possession goes to Wahoo. .6:37 left in the game. Flip it way out. Here comes the three-point shot. It is good by Hancock. 20 points for Mike Hancock, who will end up being the leading scorer for the Warriors in the 92 or 93 state tournament. 24-point lead. And now driving for the basket and foul on the way in is Mueller. And that's going to be the fifth foul on the coach's son. And he gets a hug from his dad as he comes out. Mick Anderson, a proud papa, even after his son fouls out with only 4 points, but he had a ton of rebounds. And in to replace him is Glock. So Ryan Glock is in as Anderson is the first to foul out. Justin is a senior playing his final game. Eric Mueller, also a senior, cans this one. He's got 12 points. Here's the second attempt. It's down. So it's a 55-33 ball game, Wahoo. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. Block. Looking inside, kicks it outside to Hancock, and he'll back it out and start it over again. Off it goes to Wyatt. Wyatt quickly off to Glock. Right side, it goes to Hine. Lob down low to Tolin. Tolin comes under the basket. Reverse layup. Good on his foul. Great move, Travis Tolin. Justin Anderson will be the only starter for Wahoo tonight not to end up in double figures. He's fouled out with four, but everybody else is in double digits. Tolin now has 11 points. 53, Howie is in, and Pinkelman goes out. Here comes the try for the three-point play from Tolin. It's too strong. What a bullet. Heine with a rebound. In the front court, the lob pass is up to... A lob pass to Frank. He went up with one hand, put up a shot. Eric Mueller on the foul. And did that go through or not? I don't think so. Went out of bounds. Went out of bounds. It'll be Wahoo's ball when play resumes. 5:51 left to go in the game. Wahoo 57, Hardington Cedar Catholic 33. Well, all that's left to be determined is not the winner, but the winning margin. Here comes Wahoo, up by 24 points. They led by 25. At the third quarter break. Wyatt, off it goes to Glock, to Hine. Back up top, three-point shot by Hancock. Bingo. The Sports Center has belonged to Mike Hancock. 23 points for Hancock, who's just a junior. He'll be back along with Hine and Tolin. So they'll need to replace Wyatt and Anderson. Heine on the other end, kicks it out to Mueller. His three-point shot, in and out, it won't go. And there's a foul on the rebound, whistled on Hancock. Hancock has four. So he's on the verge of joining Justin Anderson on the bench. They're going to have to find some replacements for Justin Anderson and Joel Wyant. Here's Howie's free throw attempt. He puts it up, and it's good. 60-34. Come on, guys, let's get this one over with, and let's go home and watch the midnight movie. Second one is no good. Rebound, Wahoo. 5:10 left to go. Wyant across the timeline. Heine is on him. Cross-court pass to Hine. Got a Heine on one team, Heine on the other. Inside to Tolin. Seven-footer won't go. Rebound, Heine. Outlet pass to Frank. We're coming up on halfway through the fourth quarter. 26-point lead for Wahoo. In the corner. That's Heine's three-point attempt. It's no good. One shot and out as Heine grabs the rebound, drops it off for Wyatt. Wyatt quickly in the front court, goes to the hoop all the way. Oh, my gosh, what a nice move. Wyatt with 14 points. And now on the other end, Hancock picks off the long pass. Turnover, Cedar Catholic. If they make it on the other end, they'll be down by 30. Hines, spin move underneath. Oh, nice move by Hines and gets it down. 30-point lead for Wahoo. They probably won't get to their average of 93, but the margin is going to be substantial. Inside it goes, a pass to Howie, and he's fouled inside. Is that Hancock, and is he gone? If it's on Hancock, he's gone with 23 points. Mike Hancock will be back, so the 6'1 junior is not playing his final game. Hancock joins Justin Anderson on the bench. But Mike's about to help the Warriors add another state championship trophy to their case. Howie's free throw is no good. Hine with a rebound. Hine quickly out of there. Will he go coast to coast? No, he gets it off to Bohati, who's in there. Wyatt back to Glock, back to Bohati. Three-point shot is no good. Rebound, long rebound to Frank. Frank on the other end has the ball stripped away and stolen by Hine. There's a long lob pass to Toline. Toline goes for the basket and is fouled on the way in. Fouled by number 53, Howie. Toline didn't get it down but got fouled. Wahoo showing everyone why. As we say, the least amount of points they've scored this year. What did I say, 76? 76 points against Syracuse. Free throw up and good. They may have to stretch a little bit to get to 76. Out comes Hines. Greg Hines played a great game. 13 points for the 6 foot junior. He'll be back. Out goes Heine, and in comes John Ahrens. Ahrens, a 5'9 senior. Free throw missed by Toline. Rebound to Pinkelman. So Cedar Catholic will take home the silver, and Wahoo's about ready to take home the gold. Three-point shot, Frank, won't go. Rebound, Bohati, a long up-court pass to Wyatt. Wyatt goes for the basket, gets the shot up. Oh, just missed. He almost was strong enough to get that one down. Foul is on Frank. Joel Wyatt. They're leaving him in. He's a senior. Of course, Justin Anderson, the other senior, is fouled out. 31-point lead, two shots for Joel Wyatt. The first one is no good. He's a 79% free throw shooter. He's got 14 points so far in the game. But that in no way measures his contribution. Now a 33-point lead. But they may end up with their lowest scoring total of the year. There's a penetration by Mueller, and he scores. Eric Mueller has 15 points. He will end up being their leading scorer. Three-point shot by Wyatt, short off the front. The rebound and the putback by Toline is good. Toline with 14 points. They've upped their lead to 32. On the other end, Frank, off it goes to Mueller, inside to Pinkelman. Pinkelman's turnaround 12-footer won't go. The putback won't go. And now a foul on the rebound, whistle on Pinkelman as he fouls Toline. And now we're about to get all sorts of substitutions. And Joel Wyatt will come out. And Joel Wyatt gets a big hand. Joel Wyatt is the big reason they have 5 state championships in the last 6 years. Also coming out, another senior, Ryan Glock. It's a big hug for Mick Anderson. Let's see who's in there now. Brett Eady is in there. At the line is Toline, and he's about to come out. Toline's free throw is short, no good. He's got two shots coming. 43, Mike Simons is in there. 33 is Bohati. Wotipka's in there, I believe. Louis Wotipka. Second free throw is good by Toline. Wait a minute, there was a lane violation evidently, so Toline is going to get another free throw. He wasn't in three-point range. 2:36 left. Next free throw is no good. The rebound by Pinkelman. And waiting on the sideline is Dan Brown, waiting to check in. Pinkelman, his pass deflected out of bounds by Bohati. And there goes Travis Toline. Travis Toline, the last starter out of the lineup, replaced by Dan Brown. And now we've got a timeout. 2:28 left to go in this Class B championship. Wahoo 69, Cedar Catholic 36. Well, here we go. It's just get the last 2:28 over with and let's go home. Mueller. And it comes to Arnes. Cross court pass to Frank. Out of the corner as Mueller misses. They crash the boards. Put back by Frank. It's no good. High to grab the rebound is Louis Wotipka. Wotipka down court pass to Bohati. Bohati. Off it goes to Simons. Tries to jam it inside to Brown and it's knocked away. We've got a foul here on the Warriors. So unless Wahoo can score another 7 points in the next 2:07, they'll have their lowest offensive output of the year. At the line is Dennis Pinkelman. Free throw is good. Count it. Pinkelman makes them both. He's got 6 points. Here comes Wotipka. Off it goes to Edie. That's been a familiar name at Wahoo, too. Edie penetrates, gets it off to Wotipka. Kicks it out to Bohati. Simons. Simons looking inside. Nothing going. Gets it back out to Wotipka. Wotipka. Bounce pass off to Simons. He penetrates and is fouled on the way in. Almost got it down. Fouled on the way in by 21 John Arnes. A minute 42 left to go. Let's just let this go, guy. Just let the clock run. Keep the clock going. 41. Brian Kinney checks in. 55. Dwayne Becker's in. 35. Mark Keane comes in. 21. John Ahrens is in there. Here's the free throw attempt by Simons, and it's no good. Rebound to Pinkelman. Off it goes to Kinney. Minute 35 left to go. Cedar Catholic with the basketball. Skip pass over the top. Fumbled momentarily by Arnes. Now down inside, it's kicked out of bounds. Last touch by Mike Simons. A 31-point lead for Newman, or for Wahoo. And now checking in for Cedar Catholic is number 45, Hookstein. Hookstein is a 6'4 freshman. The pass deflected, inbounds pass stolen by Wahoo. Coming up with it is number 31 in there, and the shot is up and good by 21. 21 is Edie. We don't have a 31. There's a steal and the breakaway by Wotipka, and he scores. They're trying to get it up to 76. It's up to 73 with less than a minute remaining. Wotipka with the basket. Arnes, off it goes to Kinney. And there's a shot up partially blocked by Keane. The rebound and the putback by Becker is no good, but we've got a foul. Come on, guys. Let's get this one over with. At the line will be Dwayne Becker.
Dwayne Becker at the free throw line.
A 35-point lead for Wahoo. Shot is up and good by Becker. Here comes the second free throw, and it's good. Now we've got number 15, Scott McGregor's going to get into the game for Becker. 45 seconds left to go. Come on, guys, let's get this over with. Simons, off it goes to Otipka. Otipka, up court pass. We've got number 31, and we don't have a name for him. It's almost stolen away. They get it off to Otipka. Inside, the shot is up and no good. We've also got 53 in there. We don't have a 53. So Mix run in some players on us here. It won't make any difference. Let's see who's at the line. Ryan Fiala is in there. Number 31 is Josh Anderson. Fiala scores. Josh Anderson and Ryan Fiala are the two players that are in there. Second free throw by Fiala is no good, but at least he can say he scored a point in the state tournament. He's just a freshman, though, so he may be around for a while. Wahoo almost steals it. Now Cedar Catholic bounces it off a Wahoo player. 22 seconds left to go. 34-point lead for Wahoo. So we had three really close, exciting games and three that were absolute blowouts. Wotepka steals the inbounds pass. Wotepka drives, scores. No, it won't count. Offensive foul. Louis Wotepka with a good move to the basket. Steamrolled a couple of Cedar Catholic players and picks up the offensive foul. Now let's get this one over with, guys. Here we go. We're down to 15 seconds in the front court. Comes Arnes. Inside shot is up and good by number 41. That's Brian Kinney. Brian Kinney, long down court pass is picked off, and we got a foul. 1.8 seconds left to go, and a foul is called. Let's get this over with, guys. Fiala commits the foul, and we'll go down to the other end. None of this makes a bit of difference. At the line will be Russ Hookstein. Hookstein's free throw is no good. They battle for the rebound, coming up with it. There's a long desperation shot, way short. Final score, Wahoo 74, Huntington Cedar Catholic 42.